Alright, ladies and gentlemen, everyone out there in the crowd, a warm welcome. The arena is back. The dynamic duo is back.
Dynamic
the craziest
duo.
Players on planet Earth. They are back as well for our big, big showdown. And I say that with a little tear running down my face, Fabs. Welcome everyone our PS4. Top 8, the last showdown, Fabs, for Mortal Kombat 11. And of course, we invited Mr. Handsome here next to me once again because so many people love him. Fabs, what's poppin', brother? Nice to have you here.
Man, going crazy.
Rips Arena, we are paying out these players tonight. Let's take a look at our lineup. Here it is. Makuran Taki.
Oh my god.
First set of the night. Fabs, I think both of us, when we talked about the top 16, we mentioned that Makuran always
that
making
Makuran
it to the top 8.
That Makuran performance was nuts, bro. His game versus Silva was amazing. His game versus Yuvility was even absolutely more insane. But now he has to face Takinata, the Sub-Zero man himself.
That is Makuran's nightmare. We mentioned it earlier. Makuran always, in the last 12 seasons, losing to Sub-Zero in top 8. Let's see if Makuran can rewrite history today. Versus one of the best subs, we got Rinsler versus Desarded. That means another Sub-Zero brother here in
Rinsler
the winner's
had a crazy,
side.
Crazy run as well against Blackout. That game went to game 5. It was insane. They were duking it out. I love that. I think he pulled out the Kano in the last one against Blackout. And I was like, yeah, main versus main, whatever the hell was going on in there. Mm-hmm. It was great. Desarded as well. Amazing performance.
Yes.
On this entire top 8.
Very,
and
very
then,
solid run from the sub brothers here. We have Jetring in the lower side versus Soulset, a match I personally look forward to a lot. Jetring, our only NA player who is left in this bracket after Blackout, unfortunately lost to Soulset here in the lower side. Interesting. He has to make his country proud tonight. And then last but not least, we got Starks versus Yuvility, the battle of the tier list, Fabs, our Jax loyalist.
That would be crazy. The Jackie matchup, the mother and the dad and daughter matchup. I'm literally mixing myself right now. This is crazy. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this because top 8 are supposed to be hype, okay? And these players got here for a reason.
Yes.
And so, they're about to duke it out.
Everyone in the crowd right now, once again, before we dive into this first match, you can see the players are already in the character select screen. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for tuning in. And now sit down, grab a cold one and relax with us. The last MK11 top 8 here in the arena. So let's go crazy together. Let's celebrate and let's get ready for MK1. We're diving right in. Let's get it, baby.
We're free from this game. I mean, just kidding, but still. It's a relief. It's a relief and also like a little hurtful, you know, but it's good. Let's go. First match of the day. This top 8. We got Makuran with the Scarlet and Takinata with the Sub-Zero. Nothing too crazy. He is using Rising Eyes, which is more combo potential, more damage off the board. Now having the safety of keeping Eyes that has the damage all the bursts of Sub-Zero can bring out on the table. So let's go. Boiling point already. Life lead is looking 30% for Makuran already on this stage, which is pretty important too, since you have like good conversions on that interactable.
Fibs, Rips bald head in the chat. They're like, Rips, get that wig ready because I'm going to take over the arena tonight. Thank you so much for the support. And what can I say, guys? It helps tremendously. Thank you for subbing to the channel. Thank you for just being around and being a part of this. Mako, starting
already
with some
high-octane
gameplay.
Yeah, I already saw him floss blocking a 4-4. Oh, he input a floss block there as well. Ooh, that's going to hurt him a little. Corner carry. Oh, I love this interactable. I love this interactable. It offers so much versatility. Not only is it a grab, you can armor it and it's going to launch you. Good. Nice awareness.
Please recover.
Something that we don't want. And that already happened on the first game.
Not in top 8 here. Not in our
NRS,
last top
please.
8, ladies.
Oh, the servers. Could this be the...
Oh, that Taki is definitely capable of bringing this back whenever he's feeling like it. 1-0 Marco, and maybe he can definitely need that little head start.
I know, because you know, this is a Sub-Zero matchup. Your life just flashes in front of your eyes, and boom, one game down. So, let's go.
Round one, fight.
All right, you see that just measuring each other. It's what I like to call it. You know, we're not throwing anything too crazy. You're just poking and stuff like that. One, something I've seen Takinata doing a lot is standing two into down one a lot. Or down one, standing one, down one a lot. Like, using that lately, and it's really good. He has like a pressure method, right? And Magran playing from a sweet spot, as you can see, like leaving you in the corner and just playing from that 3 meter distance kind of thing. He can get to him whatever he wants, but still, Takinata hasn't had his turn yet to do something yet, but there we go.
Feeling very, very comfortable. I'm pretty sure he warmed up for this. And I mean, the entire chat is going crazy. Level 3 hype train here on the Twitch site. Thank you guys so much for the support. Marco looking for that boiling point.
Been playing so safe, not taking any risks right now, because he knows you don't want to give Sub-Zero like any sort of momentum on this situation. There we go. Talking out of getting things started, but no, loses his turn right after. Oh, the micro. Okay, keeps it unbreakable as well, and that
so
might be
smart. Amplify, and now I'm pretty sure he can chip out in the long run. Taki has to find that opening. Jumping anti-air, he is
hold
still
on
in this,
second.
But Marco with the trip guard. Beautiful back dash, standing one to the face. Let's go.
Even under pressure, he finds a little space to create so he can secure the round without taking too many risks. Amazing. That forward two isn't coming, and we know. Breakaway out. Down one into teleport. Oh, Takinata had to punish down, but I don't think he believed in it.
What is my bald head doing it?
Bald head is going crazy
Rip
today.
Bald head right now. He is trying to crush that sub goal all on his own. Can we get some big R's in the chat for that ridiculous community support?
Watch another false block. Jesus Christ. Magran playing really, really good, but Takinata hasn't been able to like confirm or like start anything whatsoever. Seems to be struggling with his offense. Here we go, gets the throw.
Good
grab, Taki. Involved in this.
But he needs more than this trap. It's not gonna be enough. And it looks like Taki has a little brain lag here and there, or is it just me? He just looks a little bit clueless from time to time.
There we go. Get some jacket. I feel like he's having issues getting stuff started right now. I don't know why. Controller died maybe? Who knows?
It just looks like he is not playing like he's usually playing, right? We see a little bit confusion here and there.
His movement is looking a little like stiff as well. I'm not sure what's going on.
Maybe the Zard is distracting him there in the back. Who knows?
Zard is like playing something in the background, like dancing around and sabotaging this guy.
They started dancing with his Genshin Impact body pillow in the back, distracting Takinata. I see exactly what's going on.
Oh, he read the breakaway and he got the conversion as well. Jesus, Makaran out of his mind right now.
There
we go. Takinata getting something from that neutral ice ball. Freaking jumping. Bamboo arm Sub-Zero. Here we go. Looking for the crushing blow. 33. Nice walk back. Plus. Oh, he had a confirm. Oh, he missed the confirm right there. He could actually take in the game.
One makes. Oh, the down one. Marco looking to get his turn. Full strength. That means Marco's turn. Uncorrectable.
Another.
Close. Back to get blocked.
Block it.
Taki was ready.
He was. I've seen a lot of situations where Makaran just does a back two and he usually takes a round, but Takinata was very, very well aware of that. So, and I mean, his reward is a big punish as well. So. Good stuff
great
there.
Awareness from Taki. I mean, Makaran put his entire life there on the line with that back two. Had to pay the price for it. Taki was able to react. And man, I'm getting emotional here. I see so many great people in the chat. Big Koos here as well saying, good to have you back, Ribs. Koos, honestly, you cannot believe how happy I am that I'm able to host the season finals here with the community. I honestly was very, very sad, Fabs, when it first looked like we had to put the entire season 15 finals off stream, right? That was the original plan.
That was going to be crazy. Yeah, honestly, as soon as I saw that on Discord, I was like, damn, that's not very, very good for the players. I immediately was like, yo, can we do anything about that? Like, what's going on? It's coming out soon. Here we go. Game 3 now. Now I can see Takinata playing a little bit more comfortable after whatever was going on. And Jesus Christ, that was kind of painful to see. But hey, it's still game though. Equalized. First to win 2 games pretty much moves on. So let's see what happens. This stage is also the biggest stage in the game. So whoever has the zoning advantage will have to make the other one chase each other.
The 6th frame down one, putting in work. Marco tries to whiff punish that bad boy.
In the fairy there. Oh my god, there we go. That down two whiffing is an opening that tagging out of all much needed. Tongue, such a nice button to put in neutral, you know, it just establishes so much presence. And it's good chip damage as well. Nice block, but. Oh no, he's not blocking. Getting two.
Down one, good interrupt from Marco. Jumping ballsy, especially versus a player like Taki, who anti-airs left and right. Where is the hit confirm?
He missed the confirm once again. That, those are hit confirms that are literally free way tickets to get the game. Oh, and just like that, you miss yours, he hits his. And we move on to the next round.
He literally just tried to mash his way to victory. Two down ones on block and still try to press after.
Yeah, he tried to extend his offense right there against Makaron, but now Makaron knows when it's his turn to press, and he knew he had some priority over there in that situation. Oh my god, that whiff was nasty! Sustaining one slight walk back, 4-4, it's insane. But
Makaron, can he break the curse today? Is it actually time that Marco defeats one Sub-Zero in top 8? Vodka! Dropping the last three subs. There's that overhead sponsored by young Taki. Disarded cheering in the back for his brother.
Plus, oh, dash up throw now. Instead of going for the pokey, goes for the throw. Big damage right here. 9% health left for Takinata. Makaron almost smelling grand finals. And he is one step closer with that 2-1. But now, chat is demanding something right now. Even though we're celebrating this Makaron win, people in chat need something out. Oh my. They need something else. Is he muted? He is muted. I can't hear you. Oh, there we go.
For the very first time in the new, it looks so stupid.
It's the funniest thing ever.
Imagine someone on YouTube finding us for the first time. Fast.
They're like, what is going on?
And they browse through the match and all of a sudden they just see that.
This guy just went to Turkey for like 2 seconds. In the game, he went to Turkey. That's where the prize pool went, guys. What's going on? Anyways, back into game 4.
Oh, that is right. Ooh. And everyone out there, welcome to Wix Arena.
Wix Arena. Oh my god, try to up to that, but still, this is his turn. Takinata. Looking good on offense. Oh, good whiffs to throw. Why did I say that? Seems like Makaron is having a good time and just keeping his life lead and playing super safe.
Yes, Makaron is on match point.
There we go. Talking out of putting a little bit more risk behind his game plan to get that life lead. Oh, that didn't whiff punish. He gummed him. Looking super strong. This might kill.
Marco, wait, the Rob is on the horizon, Fabs. I can see it.
40% health. Oh my, the triple. No,
the confidence. Versus a player like Taki, who is able to duck as so many throws. He just dashed up full screen and grabbed this man.
I know. He did not fear poke, did not fear duck OS, did not fear jump, did not fear nothing. Just triple dash into grab, into a fake Sub-Zero that has fatal blow unlocked, which is crazy. Looking good so far. Makaron, I think this is what he needed on this game plan. Now, oh my god, the reversal flash, mark up two in the poke.
This is the other way. Wins it.
There we go. Oh, he just walks into. Okay, this is gonna hurt. He's gonna be full screen as well. Makaron potentially setting up for the nail in the coffin here.
Trades.
Oh, the boiling point trades. That would have actually killed.
And that was an input error on Makaron's end, Taki.
One mix up and he kills. Ooh! He strikes something!
Takinata!
I know! He's blocking for his life! And Takinata survives another round. Oh my god. That air to air was everything he needed. Jesus, I saw him. He was fuzzying. Like, just. I don't know what to say. This is crazy. Takinata, still alive.
Crouch blocking, stand blocking. He was trying to guess for his life.
Once Zero has you in that situation, it's over. And now he's conditioned. And now Takinata is in the driving seat on this game.
Yeah, Takinata, one of those players. He can smell Makaron.
This hurts. Almost 40 off of that breaker.
Attack, Taki.
No fatal blow. For Takinata. Always at 50 health. Gets the hit. Gets the last pressure blow. This is gonna hurt. Throw range now. Any throw would kill. Oh, he tries to jump. Nice conversion from Taki. That was sick.
And Takinada made it. It looked so close to being over there for that particular moment. But Taki is saying, hold my ice axe. I'm bringing this back, baby. And we are going to the very, very first game 5 of the night. I see the chat already going crazy. I know you guys on YouTube cannot see the live chat. But let me tell you this. They're going crazy right now. We are going to set the arena on fire. Fabs is here. I'm here, and the best players in the world, they are here, and they want to secure that juicy, juicy prize pot.
I know. How convenient it is. First game of the night, also a game 5, and I love that.
I'm going to press the button. Chat, put your seatbelt on. Here we come.
Let's go. The final match. First game on. Amazing. As you can tell from previous games we were watching, we did not see many crazy stuff from both of these players, and that was the first raw spot I see so far. I'm talking about, this is how tame he's been playing. And as a Sub-Zero player, you expect some more craziness, but this guy, wow, the back one, it's here. Ice Ball, I'm unbreakable as well. Big damage. Oh, he drops it! Still has the advantage somehow. Oh my god, he's playing a little bit more unsafe now. Getting those jump ins connecting as well. Good stuff. Are we getting it? There we go. We do get the crushing blow. He's spending his money early on to get that round. Any advantage on the set. For the first time, actually.
Oh, the down two. Taki is saying stop jumping. And now the tables have turned, Fabs.
Taki not on set point right now. And for Macron, feeling the pressure that he always feels against the Sub-Zero players that have been eliminating him on every single arena finals. Can he do it? Just throwing it out with no meter as well. How confident do you have to be to get that? Wow. And that might be close to ending. He's in throw range now. Tries to shimmy. Locked. Nice whip on it.
Yeah, get some life back. Smart decision in that moment.
Into throw. Are we seeing a nice ball neutral from Takinada? We do get one. Blood ball there. Getting some. Oh my god, that was crazy.
Jimmy, get over two.
And that's it.
And that is all she wrote. Takinada, after losing in the first round due to connection problems, he made it and he is now in winner's finals. Congratulations, Makoran on the lower side.
You can tell Takinada played so much more confidently in the last few games. You know, he was going for every time his jump ins connected, he was going for even more pressure. And it happens. A little mistake here and there from Akron and might have costed him the whole set. But yeah, Takinada just played a super, super crazy these last few rounds.
Let's take a look at our last MK11 bracket. Thank you guys so much for being here. Fabs, more than 250 people live here with us. That is ridiculous. Thank you.
Let's go. And just like that, we have the first player in winner's finals.
And his name is Takinada. Coming up next, it is another blockbuster waiting for all the Sub-Zero fans out there, all the three of them. It is Rinzler versus Desarted. Now it is time for the Big Bro.
Jesus Christ, another Big Bro Sub-Zero. Let's see if Rinzler can bring this, make this interesting. Maybe he gets a W in Desarted, because if you get a winner's finals of the Sub-Zero brothers once again, that would be crazy. That would mean Desarted can potentially get the eighth, you know, but let's see. Let's see what happens.
Maybe you're right. So the players are already in the lobby. Whenever we have Fabs here next to me, these events, they literally are like super smooth. Whenever Fabs is here, I'm pretty sure the players are afraid. You know, Fabs is an authority at this point. So they're like, you know what? Let me get into this lobby real quick. Rinzler versus Taki. Let's take a look at the characters.
All right. Rinzler, what's the Cabal pick? I like that, honestly. Because you want to, like, if you're playing against a Sub-Zero player, you want to make sure you have your offense as annoying and as difficult as possible to deal with. And Cabal has that on his inventory. Cabal, if the moment he steps in, he jumps up, you have to respect him, you know? So he does have that. If he's a neutral, all he has to do is jump, and boom, he's dangerous.
The cold will slow you down.
Whatever, I'll run faster. Running on ice is ill-advised.
Round 1.
Even though
I love that intro. I love it. I think that was the first time I heard it.
There's so much content in this game that I haven't even fully... It's not much. NRS gives so much content on every single aspect of the game. That's why I love them. Oh my god, interrupting him, the back one from the back one himself. Amazing. Using interactable that we all know I love, but it's kind of hard to convert off of.
Little Oonga Boonga happening right here. Rocking the hair airline variation name.
Airline. God damn it.
Yo, and Robo in the chat as well. Robo, welcome.
Oh, a couple input areas here from Rinsler. And you see Desarta playing with us, keeping ice to have a little bit more safety on his block string and neutral in general. And he's abusing that as much as he can, because if you connect 2-4-2's creeping ices, you get like 30% damage. All safe as well. So, plus, challenges the plus frame. But that's gonna hurt. Gets his break rate immediately. Desarta on the freaking driving seat the whole time. That was crazy conversion. Back two, that's a good whiff finisher. Back throw as well, getting as much as he can from his life lead.
Shimmit, armor break.
Yo, Rinsler has the Oki advantage. What will he do? Oh, he misses the jump in. Hasn't been able to hard his pressure so far. He might see 50 Kano, unless Kano doesn't do well in this matchup. I don't see why he wouldn't go to his main. Started. Gets the first game.
Yep. He seems to be really comfortable. Sniped him, winning that air-to-air battle. Desarta is on the board first. 1-0 lead.
Yeah, seems to be playing really comfortable in this situation. So let's see what Rinsler brings up next game to not give Desarta an easy time.
Oh no. Oh no. My mother just sent me a message. Hi, Dennis. I'm watching right now.
Amazing. Amazing. He gets to see the Wigs Arena. Exclusive.
I told her I'm a professional commentator.
We love Mama Rips, you know? Exactly. Be like,
and she's going to see me with the wig.
Do you like what you see?
Okay, but all you guys in the chat, now you have to bring the extra hype for Mama Rips. 1-0 this, let's get it.
Let's go, and Rinsler goes to the Baraka pick here. I like this variety that he's bringing to the table. I wonder what he thinks that makes Baraka a good choice, and he already has life lead this quick in the neutral. Nice counter pokes, and oh, I'm guessing he wants to get the mix-ups on board. He whips it. Oh, whipping because you hit something is so painful. He's gonna pay for price for that. I'm liking so far how Desarta is playing super consistently. That was a sick conversion, getting his breakaway.
Jimmy doesn't believe, but one overhead is enough, Fabs.
I know.
No hit confirm on that.
Oh, he wins that. And Rinsler takes it with this Baraka. I'm liking what I see.
Round 2, fight.
Oh, he was actually blocking for like a split second right there. There you go. Gets the side switch breakaway in for Rinsler. And he falls into the mix machine. Blocks low. There we go. Oh, he was pressing a little too early and Rinsler was still doing something. Where are you positioning? This might kill if he goes for the full cash out. Oh, he drops it.
Okay.
Nice blocks. Rinsler just needs to get out of the corner, honestly.
Oh, trades with that command grab attempt.
Nice block. Still surviving as much as he can. But, oh god, he wanted to leave the corner, but Desarta keeps the offense going. Keeps that pressure. We get a final round now. Game 2. Reversal throw, good, I guess, misplacement on that situation. See the backdash movement there from Desarta, just backing away in neutral, even though it was his turn. I think he's does not want to take many risks against his character. But Rinsler is going ham. Punishes, this is gonna hurt.
Oh shit, look at this. Damage, 36 to the kisser. tried the poke special, but Desarded, he knows how to punish that.
Okay, Desarded, Cash is on the figure blow kind of early, but that's because it's going to do like 45% damage off the board right now. And that's good to have, because he can save his next meter for what to play.
Oh no.
No breakaway there, interesting. Fatal Blow in play? No Fatal Blow! Rinzer did not need the Fatal Blow. I was about to. If he didn't kill...
He was... Look at him putting down the gang signs. Rinzer, he is here to play Jet. 1-1 Desarded, potentially in trouble.
I like what Rinzer did there. He backed off away. Reads that Desarded is going to wake up 3. Dashes up, gets the full punish on that, and continues. That was Fabs, probably what gave him the win.
Isn't it just crazy, everyone, that... There is a prize pool of 2,000 euro on the line, and Rinzler is sitting there in the character select screen, and he's like, you know what? Let me go Baraka.
That's crazy. That's honestly insane.
That's why he's the GOAT.
He might be. Black Dragon fight. And now timer, if he continues this up, you know? I respect that a lot. He did try Kano. I mean, Cabal, which didn't really work, but...
Rinzler is challenging Desarded to go for the Baraka Mirror in the chat, but Desarded is like, you know what, let me stick with Zan. Fight.
Baraka does have some mix in his toolkit, but doesn't have the great tools on his inventory.
Yo, Robo, thank you so much for the gifted sub to Xephyr.
Hammer interactable, 20% damage. I love these interactives in this game, especially with the armor.
Command grab.
Oh, the lunge. 20% damage. I mean, 12% damage for that. It's so good. Nice blocks. Press to press. Nice. I like that. How he's not willing just to stand still and look at Sub-Zero being Sub-Zero. You know, he's pressing. He's being active, honestly. That's what you need to do if you're playing against Sub-Zero.
I like that after all this conditioning from Rinzler with down one chop chop, Desarded is a little bit afraid to take his turn.
I know. I see him back away in neutral as well, but now we're getting into Fatal Blow territory. Missing it. What?
Get him out, Chet! Get him out!
Okay, we get into Fatal Blow territory, and he immediately throws that out in neutral. Like crazy.
He just smashed that!
Wow. Desarded was going for his turn, but I guess you're not going for your turn. You'll get fatal on neutral. I love this. Oh my, what's going on?
Sliding left and right.
What's going on over here? Overhead. Might be slow, but it hits. Rinzler getting somewhat of a nice life feed right here.
Rinzler. Nice. Rinzler, what is he doing? Rinzler, this is the seventh time arena check. Punish.
He would have actually killed right there if he had that punish on the roll. Rinzler, hope he doesn't get to his head now because Desarded will have the offense right now. Don't get mixed. Oh, he gets hit. Will we see a reset? No, he wants to get the breakaway. Or the full cash out, whatever works for him. He needs it.
Good luck.
Nice blocks. No fair to play. Has his turn. Let's you place. Oh, he's whiffing. He had to win. Oh, the chop chop. Go what? The thousand chop chop!
No, Rinzler, brutal. Rinzler, can you please chill?
This might have been the most demonic win I've seen in a while. Takes the first round with a neutral fatal, and takes the second round with thousand chop chop in 2023, September.
I think we have to give Rinzler a reminder that this is not a random King of the Hill. This is our season 15 grand final. Rinzler doesn't give a shit.
He's making people remember how things are supposed to be in tournament, you know? I love this. We're getting every single year of MK11 right here in front of our eyes to close it off, you know, after 4 years of sweat. Black market. 4.5 years, actually, which is crazy.
And I hate to say it right now, but it looks like the entire chat is rooting for Rinzler and his Baraka.
You might be. They might be. The Baraka, the champion of the people. What is going on? Round one, fight. Wow. Desarded needs to lock in right now. Otherwise, the winner's finals is just around the corner. And he whiffs the back two, and Rinzler is not sleeping on that. I almost got the punish on that down. You want to break away immediately.
Oh, good basic from Disordered, the little micro backdash.
So good for having that backdash back three on his inventory. Disordered right now, he knows that Rinzer's respecting what he's doing, and he's just abusing that. Also has a throw KB on his inventory right now. And that was all Disordered. He knows the moment you get conditioned by Sub-Zero, he will do whatever he wants. Free throws, free 4-2s, free mix, everything. Nice. You can see Dizard is neutral ducking right there, expecting those lunges. Nice. Good blocks. Gets the breakaway, surely. No down two there, but still keeps something going. Nice conversion. There we go, the 4-2 of Doom right there. The problem is he gets a little, oh god, the wake up 4-4. It's the lunge right after. Rinzer getting close to finishing this. Rinzer. Oh, he gets it. Oh my god.
Man, Pips, I love every single second of this match so far. Rinzer playing the match of his life.
Sitting on set point right now. Fatal blow, still in play. Question blow, still in play as well. I know. Oh my, oh, this Harden is completely conditioned right now. He just threw 4-4 into freaking... What's going on today? Oh, the counter pokes. This Harden is being even more hesitant. I mean, more impatient on his defense. There we go. He's pressing a lot on defense, and he does not care. And I like that.
Random slide from Disordered worked.
Disordered is making it work right now. About to close it. Can he do it?
Down two to seal the deal. I mean, ladies and gents, you expect? This is our top 8 finals. It is time for another game 5.
Jesus Christ. Back-to-back game 5s, and we see Rockets and Zero fighting for the top, for the winner side, pretty much. Fighting for top 3 at this point. And I love that.
Man, these matches, they are crazy. Rinzler, he has a dream.
Now, will he keep the Baraka or switch to Kano?
I'm honestly going to lose it. If he stays with Baraka, he is going back to Kabal.
The character who he lost in the first game. I'm not sure if I agree with that. But if he thinks it's good, then we have to follow. We have to believe in him. Disordered just has the momentum right now. I mean, he already beat both of his characters, so he's like probably unfazed. Alright, let's see who takes game 5 of the second set of the night.
Wait, what?
God is up to blocked and he immediately down tuned because he probably knew that Rinzer was gonna try and go for sending one punish on that. Which is demonic and I love it. Here we go. Loses the air to earth with Kabal. Interesting. Oh my god, those down twos are coming from everywhere. There we go, the mix.
Real. Yes, that overhead is definitely.
There we go. Disordered sitting on set point right now on his way to winner's finals.
Round 2, fight.
Rinzer knows he has the air positioning as well. He has, oh my god. Disordered is down twoing the hell out of him. Not seeing much of air pressure here from Rinzer. Seems to not really be doing gaslight on anything, really. Like the jump three pressure in the air.
Just the hash up down two from Rinz. Jimmy, and did he hit confirm that or did he just believe?
I don't know. Disordered is close to ending this. Oh!
Oh, fast.
Disordered gets it. He gets it. He knows. He was calm. He was calm with it. He just to both.
This match is over. Disordered, just like his brother in round number 1, they brought it back.
They did. They did. They were both down in the set and they flipped it. Now they both have to face each other in winner's finals with the Sub-Zero mirror. I hope you guys are ready for that because I definitely am as well. All right. Now we get to see some lower bracket action.
Good that you say it. Let's take a look at that sweet, sweet lineup, everyone. We are now in the lower side of our bracket, and I see two very, very familiar names over there. Jetring and So Sad. That means potentially Joker versus Collector.
Yeah. Joker Collector, I don't think I've seen that matchup actually happen.
It is definitely a matchup we don't see that often.
I don't know what I can say on paper. Like, Joker just has a neutral advantage because of all of his tools and how they work. But I noticed how So Sad was playing with his Collector, and I feel like on neutral, he's so, so scary with the command grab and all the long range buttons he has and the mix ups as well. So let's see.
And again, the most professional tournament is back. Look how smooth that transition is to the next game. We are already in there, baby.
The spawn. One thing a spawn is, he hits you and he hurts a lot, but I feel like on neutral, he needs a little bit more to have an advantage over Joker. I think he has that low hell chain move, pretty sure. Raising hell.
I think
that's the move. Wait, is it? I don't think it is. I think he has a restand, not the move I'm thinking he does, but let's see how it goes. Jet Ring.
85 on Soul.
Wow. Jet Ring being considered the underdog in a situation. There we go. There we go. He does have the move. Okay. I thought it was the restand. That move is a crazy criminal offense in neutral. Look how much it gives you. The 10% safe spectrum is going to put you like almost full screen. There we go. Jet Ring making this Joker work. Get shimmy. Both guest characters as well. In a Mortal Kombat match, this is authentic NRS stuff.
Good snipe. Nice. Enter from So Sad.
Good stuff. So Sad. Get in the first round. First blood on the set. Oh, tries to whiff punish him with the gloves. Kind of not the safest thing to do, especially against Spawn, since he can just punish that with charging House Spawn. Big whiffs. There you go. That straight projectile from Spawn is so, so good. If you don't have something to fight back, that projectile is going to suppress you really easily neutral. Movement. Nice. Gets that punish on the down two. Took his time, but still punished it. And there we go. Jet Ring finds the whip punish. He just finds the hooker for him, pretty much. 33. Both players are pretty much one confirm away from killing each other, if you think about it. Now he's gonna have Fatal Blow. God, he's trying to shimmy. Jet Ring needs a confirm into Fatal with Joker. Oh, he goes for the throw. Okay, that's 30%.
Can we spend it? There it is.
Excellent. Well, 12% versus 20% life lead. He's one mix up, one auto shimmy, one throw, one anything really. He's gonna go for strike throw. No, he does not. Backs away as well. I think he's waiting for his bars to come back so he can have another Jack in the Box. But time is running out, and he has a life lead.
The jumping connects. He put his life on the line with that one.
That was risky, and I like that. No anti-air there. Seeing some whipping situations here. Whenever he does a string into projectile, Joker makes the first projectile whip. So if Jet Ring can take advantage of that, he's a nice confirm. Nice. 25 unbreakable as well. There we go. In the throw. Getting the neutral reset. He does have a life lead, so he shouldn't have too many issues chasing him. There we go. Backed away.
Tries to shimmy, but So Sad is patient. Still caught him with the very end of the string.
Good positioning as well. Yeah, I think he's looking for another jump in from Jet Ring. Oh my god. Guess the hit he was looking for. The short hop? I like that. I respect it. Buying some more time. I think if he gets the Fatal Blow back, he will definitely try and go for confirm and kill him. Here we go, fatal blowback.
That was it. Oh, he was looking for that.
Oh, wait, it was that input error from Jazz. Oh, Jesus. Got Christ. Him mid air.
Scary. Both of these players playing the set. I mean, playing the games until the almost final moments of the timer. So, good stuff here from both. That's 1-0. You're so sad with the spawn pick. And I thought I was going to see some collector action, but I guess he has something even better for us.
I think so said he knows what he's doing with that spawn pick. And right now it looks like it's working out. Let's see, Jetring, he has a lot of different characters, but for now it looks like we're sticking it out with Joker. And I see Alexis in the chat. Yo, welcome. Saying, what did I miss? Some crazy, crazy fights, a lot of game fives, and right now it is Jetring versus Soset here in our grand finals.
Let's see. Soset looking strong off of that first game. Let's see what Jetring can do different. Like I was saying, if he starts punishing those fireballs that Soset is doing on block, the first hit whiffs against the Joker. So he can just duck the first one and punish it immediately with a 4-2 crushing blow. So, oh, the poke special's coming in. There we go. That poke special is so, so good. It creates so much space as well. And the chip damage it does is insane as well. Oh my god. Oh, okay, picking him midair. Mid whiff as well. How does Jimmy? Joker, like one of those characters that has one of the strongest strike throws in this game.
Oh, good interrupt with that down one from Soset. Try to mash you, Jetring.
Another auto shimmy that he's cooking with those so far. Jetring knows what Joker is strong, and he's abusing that as he should, really. Fight.
Wait, what?
That was crazy. What the hell made him do that? He had no breakaway either, so that would have, he would have died if he went for that and he got blocked. Another throw. Hold on a second. Jetring trying to get a life lead right now, just so he can back away again. Sweep. Oh, nice anti-air. There we go. Life lead for Jetring now. Doesn't need to do nothing too crazy. Wins the trade again. Movement. Oh no. No breakaway for both now. Oh god.
Well, that was the opening on the second hit. So hard to confirm this.
Oh my god, that's gonna kill. Wait, will it? This breakaway is not gonna come in time. Down two.
Oh, that is big. Boy, damage, and all that is sponsored by Jetring to tie this up.
He's done. Yeah, he literally cashed out on the crushing blow and did the combo right before he got his breakaway back. So, good stuff there. Nice awareness from Jetring as well.
The last hope for North America here in our finals, Fabs. Jetring versus EU at this point.
I know, he's literally fighting solo against EU in this situation. I'm happy for him, honestly. Let's go. Let's see if he can make it happen.
And once again, guys, thank you so much for all the support, especially to the people who are so generous and even subscribe to the channel and gift subs here to support this entire project. We love you guys. Thank you. Wait, Soset is switching, Fabs?
Another switch? I've seen his Cabal. I'm not gonna lie, I've seen his Cabal. This Cabal is crazy. This guy, he plays each character like on the most optimal way you can. So, if he can do what I'm thinking he can do, then nothing is really holding him back. Also, like, I feel like against Joker, he can just like do air bus saws all game, really. And if Joker does something, he jumps and gaslight and you can punish it. So, oh, he tries immediately for an air bus saw. And Jetring read that actually and down to him. What a crazy sequence we got right at the start. Oh my god. Big punish attempt. He misses it. That was his moment. And he dropped it. Now Jet Ring has a huge life lead right now. There we go. Back in the neutral game. Sosad has no life lead. I don't think he should be.
Don't do that.
No, oh my god, he's missing a lot of good damage right now. So sad. He's tightening up his offense.
I don't think Cabal can punish this.
Oh my god. Oh, gets the. Oh my. Dashes three times and catches in midair with the forward two. That button has so much range, and Joker, very much, like, just make sure that you gotta use that button sometimes, you know? That max range you can. Nice pressure from Jet Ring. I like how he doesn't really overextend his offense in this situation. He knows from where to play. He knows how long he has to pressure, and then he backs away at the perfect moment.
That's right. And look at my boys, Ketchup and Mustard in the chat saying, Rips Arena MK1 gonna be wild. I'm ready, and I cannot wait for the journey, my friend. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I can say the exact same thing right back at you. Hopefully we were able to do some stuff together for MK1. I would be honored.
That was crazy. I remember when they hosted online tournaments for MK11. Really, really cool. I forgot what the name of it was, but it's so good. Just like that, though. Focusing on what's going on here. Jet Ring.
We have one mission. We have to make EU great again. Oh, wait, do I read that right? I might try and compete in some of your cups.
Let's go. Meanwhile, though, so sad. The massive life lead and getting that
He has to spend this. No, he doesn't.
Oh, he doesn't. Okay, because he does have the run advantage right now.
Yeah, I think he wants to make it safe, you know. He can definitely take this round. Look, but here it is. Jet Ring.
Wait a second.
What is wrong?
The showdown. No, Sean. That was crazy. That was a crazy comeback.
What are you doing?
I did not expect him to have... that was crazy. That sequence with the leap, it's all that started. Like, he got the leap, makes you get on the bus saw, big punish, big cancel, and then short hop to finish it off.
But Phelps, you know what I just realized? This is the first time where Mustard and I have the same hair length. Mustard, what do you say? Do you like it? Chad, I definitely have to get that hair transplant in Turkey. I have to get it, Phelps. I think it's officially time, you know?
Might have to happen. If we ever get a pro comp, that we do a tournament in Turkey and y'all have to get there. You'll see Rips over there. I'm like, are you competing? Are you coming? No, I'm going over there to the doctor.
No, Chad, we just have to convince all our players that they fight for nothing in season one MK1, right? And the entire prize pool goes to me so I can get that hair transplant. Do you think the players are down for that, Fabs? What do you think?
Let's see. These guys are not playing around, though.
No, the players are like, where's my money?
I'm helping this guy? What? I'm helping this streamer in particular gets my help? No way. Oh my god. Another character switch here. Down to one in the set.
Bringing Nightwolf with one of the weirdest variations I've ever seen. We have to remind him that there is 2,000 euro on the line.
That is the most DLC variation I've seen in my whole life. What was that? What is this?
I'm pretty sure Jet Ring has never seen that variation in his entire life. What is wrong with DCU guys?
These guys are not playing. One guy brings Barak and the other one just brings some weird Nightwolf variation. And he's like, I don't care. I'm here to I don't care what you say. Keep this combo. Nice. There you go. Boss blocking everything he needs to boss block. That's a lot of damage, I just realized. Reflect. Oh my god. The full screen presence here from Nightwolf is looking kind of crazy.
There's the forward one.
Doesn't get shit, Mito. Doesn't anti-air. Blocks the.
No, ooh,
doesn't
finish
the short hop. Oh my god. Jet Ring getting away with murder. Short hops back to back after having short hop block. And the down two from downtown. 30%. Another throw. At 13. Almost 50% life lead right now. Looking good. Like HP projectile, by the way. What is this damage? That's like Aquaman's tentacle. It tracks. I just realized. What the hell? It's tracking projectile. That is so cool. But I just realized he has no combo potential though. His hit confirms do no damage. But he does get a lot of damage from these projectiles for sure. Has to be careful though because Jet Ring is on Matt. He jumps!
This is unbelievable.
He jumps the mix up. He jumps the mix up and so sad. Stays for another round. Could be his last, or could be his lifeline with his Nightwolf variation. What is going on my screen?
He sniped him right out of it. So sad to say, this is a no fly zone.
Oh my god.
Grabbed him, good tech.
I've never seen that. And I'm happy I'm seeing it right now. Gets up the corner, goes for the mix up. Punish, he gets a punish this time. He's really plus. Goes for the low, gets the throw. He's really plus off the throw as well, what did he do? We got overhead, we have an auto shimmy, everything. Oh, the trade. Oh my god, he held it. He held it. There you go. This is where he wants to be. So much damage. Jet Ring needs to go for a jump in. There we go. He does. Another leap. Two leaps in a row. Gets the throw. Oh my god. He's going to be full screen though. That's where Sosa wants to be anyways. So we might see a leap. Jack in the box or a leap? Jack in the box or a leap?
Yeah, Sosa is looking for it. And with Thor's Thunder Strike himself.
Oh my god.
Able to bring us to another Game 5 Fabs. Three Game 5s in a row.
In a row. What are we witnessing with a freaking Nightwolf tracking God Thunder move? Why does Nightwolf have a better Thunder projectile than Raiden, the God himself of Thunder?
That is straight up ridiculous. And all you 300 people in the live chat with us, I want every single one of you to stand up right now and go absolutely crazy for these ridiculous players. There's so much on the line. It is the last showdown of Mortal Kombat 11, and we're gonna have a little party in here. Let's get it. I'm pressing the magic button.
Let's go. Let's go. Looking insane right now. Oh my god. It generates. Zone me? Oh no. Is that a counterpick? I think it's a crazy counterpick right here that we're looking at. But wait, what is that move? You're gonna see some blue stuff, Scarlet. Oh no, he doesn't. He doesn't. Goes back to Joker. Okay. I feel like the anti-zoning would have made his matchup a little bit easier with the purple Jade stuff. But he was like, you know what? I'll go for the Joker. So sad with the hidden. I've never seen this move ever in competitive in my whole life, by the way. Never. And so sad. Pulling out in the big stage. On this map as well.
Tries to grab him. So sad.
We're jumping a lot. There we go. 13% per projectile. We'd love that. But Jet Ring gets a hit and you're gonna cry about it, honestly. Everything being thrown at him. Again,
he tries to go for the Rhino Charge, but no one's home.
Oh, the Reflex. Jesus has so much on his kit right out. Oh, big punish! Why didn't he amplify or even go for the question blow? Could have been a guaranteed round, I'm pretty sure. Oh, the down two and wake up. Fatal blow in play. And he gets the confirm for Jet Ring.
He needs it. Point. One round remaining.
Round two. Fight.
Set point for Jet Ring.
Oh, does a whiff punish.
Overhead. Plus. Goes for auto shimmy. Gets the throw. Beats out the 4-2. Or we're standing 2, actually. I think I detected the throw too early.
Oh, that doesn't finish. Oh,
that was cool. That was going to reflect. It doesn't. Oh, that's that big huge damage. You
this
might be in trouble.
Might be it.
No breakaway.
No breakaway.
So sad. Ooh, I think.
And
yeah,
that
Kettering. Nice.
Is gonna do it. Unfortunately, so sad journey here in our season 15 grand finals has come to an end. GG's, both of them played out of their minds, and I love the character picks from SoulSet here in Grand Finals, Fabs.
I know. That got me super, super hyped. But things come to an end, and SoulSet's journey is over for this top 8, ending at 7th place, which is still really good, still really good.
I completely agree with that. He can definitely be proud. I mean, making it to both finals, PC side of things, and now today, PlayStation. Cannot wait to see SoulSet back in MK1. But now, Fabs, it is time to take another look at our top 16, aka top 8 bracket. Only one match left.
Oh, this is going to be crazy.
And that is going to be Starks versus Uvility. Starks, one of our, I would call him YouTube VIPs. Starks has a shit ton of fans over there. Whenever Starks is in one of our videos, the comment section goes absolutely crazy whenever they see that Jax in action.
No, I know. The way he plays Jax, also really oppressive offense that he brings out. And then has the mids. He has the throw crushing blow is so, so hype. And you know it's coming as well. That combo he does all the time, it's huge. So yeah, good stuff to see. But on the other side, though, we have Uvility, which is pretty much a machine embodied.
Oh, yeah.
Jackie. So,
is it going to be played around versus Uvility's Jackie Bricks?
There we go. The dad and daughter. And both these characters will not be playable in the next MK. So, unlucky if you main them. There we go. Variations are the same as expected. Let's see. I remember Uvility going to losers from Makaron, and he was mostly getting anti-aired with the group mind games in mid-air that he was doing. Let's see if Starks can take some notes and already gets the first hit with that 4-3. There we go. Nice movement as well.
Yeah, I was about to mention the same.
Good movement from him. He knows how to position himself to play against Jackie. Oh, and nice. Okay, not only knows how to move, but knows when to press. Reading Uvility's timings twice so far. Reversal throw. There's a hammer as well if you need a cool 20% armor. The spacing. Goop on the floor. Oh, the 4-3 stagger. Can't really press after that with too much confidence. Oh, nice. But wait a second. Any hicker firm? Or a throw. Crushing blow. Could end the round.
And here comes Stark's chat.
Oh my god. I love this. I love this. He has those. You can never count Jax out when, like, his comeback potential is nuts. He can kill you from either a throw or from a hicker firm. Anything. There we go. Uvility. Still with the life lead. As a throw. What's for Elky? Potential jump. He goes for the jump. But, oh, these throws that Starks is throwing out are pretty, pretty dominant on the set. Nice. The low. The rare low. Minus 20, but nobody actually tries to block it.
I really like the patience from Starks. Very defensive. Uvility there. The back two overhead connects.
He's unconfirmed.
Shimmy.
Oh,
and he tried it.
I saw what he was going for. And honestly, if he hit that, he would have been in a situation where he would be like with full heated. So full heat mode on his gloves. Nice. The patience. He waited for him to literally breathe before he pressed. I say gloves. I don't care. There we go. That's not a crushing blow, though. It's a forward one that crushing blows.
Oh, nice.
That's a crushing blow, literally waiting for him from any confirm. Maybe, is that a throw whip or did he actually just duck?
I think he just duck. That's what it looked like to me.
Yeah. Bit of balloon play for your ability. Let's do a short hop.
And your ability sneaking in the fake
that.
Let them
very,
very end.
Because, I mean, like, you're expecting a lot of overhead coming from the jump in. And the low is just there. The low is just there.
Ability 1-0 lead.
Good stuff.
What is Stark's answer gonna be, Phaps? I have no idea.
I feel like he's gonna keep his jacks there. I think he might switch up his offense a little bit more. And I mean, his offense was actually good. I think he might change the defense because he got hit by that low that just should not be hitting when you're against Jackie. You know, like, you know, she has that all the time. When she's on the floor, you gotta block low. So it's crazy.
Round one, fight.
All right, starts off with the grab. Ground pound. Wins the air to wear. Good stuff. Amazing start already. If you're a Jax player, getting your near the corner in this situation looks simple.
Oh my god, it takes his turn back again.
The restart. Nice.
Man, Jackie Briggs'
oh
pressure is
god.
Just never ending.
Takes his time going for his turn. I've noticed a lot. But he gets it. Don't want to play around. Oh, again, he takes his time going for his third. Catching ability, just not blocking or anything. Looking good to get this round. There we go. Hold on a second.
Round two, fight.
Ooh, that was a nice rip cut from ability.
No, it's a 3-3 lock. Oh, God. Didn't really confirm anything. There we go. Guess the hit confirm.
And the saddest thing, Juke said that Jax beats Jackie 6-4. Black Lives Matter says that as well, by the way.
That's amazing. There we go.
Yeah, I don't
poor
think
Jackie.
It's true as
oh
well,
God.
But.
Like, poor Jackie had to lose his matchup. Oh my
what
God,
do I know? Man. Let's get back to the match. Starks!
Nice tech. Survives that.
Staying
in the game.
What a call out from Ubility on that forward two stagger.
Oh, I know. Good stuff.
Final round. Fight.
But wait, though. But wait. Stark still has his throw KB loaded as well. They're waiting, you know, to be put out. He's in full heat right now, I think.
Look at this pressure fest.
I know, right? 45 health already for Jackie.
Oh, nice back dash.
Gets the KB. He sets the gloves. Arm, sorry for chat. He's gonna complain about me. Hold on a second. Oh my god.
That combo from Starks.
No. Restand.
Back two.
Bump.
And
oh
yeah,
my
Starks
god.
Is saying this round is over. He's on the board.
That whole sequence, he just had it programmed in his head. There was no coming out of that sequence. Jesus, Starks has the combos. That was sick.
And I see all the Starks fans in the live chat. That Jax is disgusting.
So clean with it.
Can he really make this versus one of the best Jackies we have in the arena?
All right, we go for game three. Oh, tries spinning two right there.
He's stuck again.
He's voluntarily going for duck. That's so impressive. I love that. Go to the low. Forbidden low for some. Oh my god. There we go. Goes to the super string. That string is so hard to deal with.
It does so, so much for Jax.
I know, that string is crazy. You just have to like duck the first hit and then take your turn, but like he has two good mids. Can't be ducking against Jax. Double goop, and that's brown for your ability.
Just another free win.
Round two, fight.
There we go. Gets it. Every time he gets his turn back with that freaking string is so much pressure if you're on the defensive side. Because he can just stagger and then go for a throw or something.
The flawless block ability taking his turn back.
Oh my god. That's it. Here we go.
Oh my god, he moves across the screen like nothing.
There we go. Starts with pressure. Tries to press. Big ability has the first button.
The tech, that was crucial. Try to up two, but unfortunately, that string is not interruptible.
Yeah, cannot be up-toing a lot of buttons in this game. A lot of things in this game just hit too quick. Maybe an up three would have given him a turn back, but now he knows. Now he knows. The reader was there, though. Ability up 2-1 in the set.
Wait, why is the help command still in there? How did these guys even find that, Fabs? Wait. But a big shout out to the entire community who actually saved me more than once. I appreciate every single one of you.
Amazing. Hello, Holly.
Yo, Holly, hi. And Marco's saying I'm afterwards. Yes, Marco. That's right.
There you go. Starting off the round. Command grab. Oh my god, back to back. Nice positioning already. And good life lead as well. 50% life lead. Off the round start. Especially against Jackie, you should consider this a blessing, right? Because technically, he's like one hit confirm into then one grab and then that's GG.
I swear to God, if this is going into another game 5 situation, I'm going to lose it.
Be the craziest top 8 ever. Every game 5? That's insane. Oh my God, what the hell? Didn't even look real. This isn't waste time. I know. I knew he was going to go for that, even though it's overkill, but like locked around against Jackie, you know?
Round two, fight.
Nice. Meter burn. Gets the corner.
Oh no.
Oh my god.
Recovered somehow.
They didn't drop the combo somehow? What? Who is this freaking guy? Didn't drop it. That's crazy. Again in the corner. Really trying to jump, trying to press, trying to do anything to get out the corner.
Starks. Oh, he had the right idea with the spacing there.
Maybe the 4-2 there would have worked better. Pressing blow. He just the arm. Heat off. Just needs Starks, needs one hit confirm. And so does your ability, to be honest. He has fatal on his end. Oh, and the pressure gets overwhelming whenever Jackie's on the driving seat. No more meter. Gets the overhead. Rolls out the corner. I mean, the mid. No!
And your ability, Daku-esque, right under that.
He made the right read by rolling out of Oki. But then again, whenever your ability's in a driving seat with Jack, it's so hard to get out. Back to neutral, though. Back to neutral. Kitchen sink. Immediately back forward three.
Nice conversion from Starks.
I thought he was gonna get the hit right there, honestly. But good stuff though. Starks still looking pretty strong here and pretty alive in this matchup right now. Potential get the game 5? Can he get it? Plus range into throw. Oh no, another throw. Agility. Really confident with his throw placements right now. Another one with the goop on top. Almost 20% damage.
And that is it. Ability kicking Starks out of the tournament. GG's.
Since last round, he was just on a driving seat the whole time, really, with his offense. But good stuff to both, though. That's GG's. It is GG's.
And I see the beautiful Holly in the chat going crazy. What's up, everyone? Welcome to the arena. And of course, welcome to our Season 15 Grand Finals.
Now we get the macro run against Jetring.
Oh, that is true, Fabs. Yes, for Ability. Now you're with us. And now this is for top 4, yes.
Yeah.
Macron versus Jetring, a straight up banger though. Another EU versus NA showdown.
This is gonna be hype. Not very sure how I feel about seeing Scarlet Joker.
I'm pretty sure that's the matchup we're gonna see. And as always, we are already in the next set. This is smooth, baby.
I don't think I've seen this too often. Maybe back in a ESL days or something, you would see some Macaron against Law Quarter maybe as well. This matchup would happen quite often. Haven't seen that in years though. But let's see, Macaron definitely knows how to run this. And Jetring probably knows how to play against the Scarlet in 2023. So.
And as always, a big shout out here to the entire mod team. Because the predictions, they are already up there when we are in the character select. A big shout out to the great arena team.
Jetring being the underdog for 2 sets in a row. He was like only 15% last set and he took it. So any Jetring believers, you are making points today. You should get this one right again. Macron with that 1-2. Oh, and then parry. Having a nice parry placement, getting some health back and taking some from him as well. The tongue in neutral. So good. But if he makes a read on any projectile with a leap, then we have a problem here. Because it's a big hit confirm. And a reversal throw. Wow, looking good. With no one doesn't get the punish. Wow, gets a corner placement after getting
good
hit.
Spacing from Marco. And another dash up attempt. But Jetring ready for the tech.
Nice blocks. The reversal throw. He read it. There we go. Oh, no. He needs two hits. And there is it. Amazing stuff here from Macaron. He knew that he would just go for the safe option. Didn't go for a low. Didn't go for a high. Just went for double mid.
Punish.
Oh, big damage. Breakaway. Incoming from Macaron. No. Saves it. Oh my god. I like boss blocking a low a little harder. They are like kind of slow in this game. Oh, gets the health back. Ooh, and gets down 2 right after. Jetring, these down 2s are working for him. This whole top 8, to be honest. Oh, big confirm. And up 2 on wake up? Wow, that decision making is looking good for his side.
Last frames, Marco.
He knows he has no meter to punish his gaps. Oh, tries to read that mix up. A strike throw here from Joker when he gets into fatal blow is quite insane. Final round. Good stuff from Jet Ringo. Going to final round on the first game of the set.
And Phelps, I gotta say, we are watching some good MK today.
We are watching some amazing MK, I'm not gonna lie. The tongue there. Making sure he controls neutral with slow blood balls and the tongue. And he flops. He's a machine, bro. Absolute machine. Jedrin needs to find a way to play against this. Oh, wait a second. Oh, no. Yeah, whenever Scarlet hits a 4-4, you cannot break away.
Yes, and that is every single time. Ridiculous amount of damage in the corner.
Yeah, her armor breaker being also her launcher in the corner is so crazy.
Yes.
But hey, she needs it. She needs it.
And don't forget, everyone, this is actually a money match. Because in our events, there is a top 4 payout for each league. And that's what Marco and Jetring are fighting for right now. And after this, Rinsler, Uvility in the pipeline.
More action, non-stop action that we're getting today.
Round 1, fight.
There we go. Boiling point, dope. Boiling point. Jesus Christ, 30% healthy already for Macaron. Big punish from that whipping tongue. And you get a hit with Joker, for like everything just comes fluidly. Oh my god, Jesus Christ. If he teleported into Floss Block up 2, I would have lost my everything.
That
really
would have been crazy. Jesus, but again, Christ. Big damage sponsored by those high heels.
No, right? Why do her kicks do so much damage?
Shimmied.
Get shimmied? Why not?
Oh, that's a good armor break. I like the side switch as well.
So good. Plus, Gasper, freaking Pedro. Yeah, Pedro
again.
I was literally like, it's about to come out. I knew it.
Round 2.
You can see Macron's having a little of some struggles dealing with that. Again, wow, hold on a second.
Yeah, that particular Joker string might be the saving grace for Jetring in this matchup.
There we go. It's a boiling point. 28% damage. Oh, there we go. He knows that Jet Ring is immediately.
What the hell is Denarion doing in the chat? Just casually dropping a 50! Saying, I saw you drop this the other night and wanted to return it. Denarion, thank you so much, my friend. And as always, Fabs and me, we are talking for the players here.
Back.
Thank you
for
guys for the support, and Anarion, you're an absolute legend. Are we going to see you back in MK1, Anarion?
Surely. But guys, reminder, the players are giving their all right now for the last ever top 8 that we're going to get for this game. So if you have anything to give them as compensation for playing this game for that long, then this is the time. This is the time, the reward they needed. Very, very much so. Wow, good zoning here from Macron.
That was a clean whiff punish as well from Macron. Oh, the emergency down 2, Jetring.
Jetring has been hitting a lot of down 2s today, so I've noticed. Nice punish, nice awareness in there. There we go. In a situation where the life speed doesn't matter here whatsoever, because any hit would really just like turn the table. Locks the shimmy this time. Leaps away. Jack in the box. Nice. Oh. Down 2. Jetring has the craziest down 2s I've seen today. Plus, with Fatal Blow on his pockets as well. Oh, he whipped. He knew it. Plus, this turn does not end. Macaron's turn has been going for like at least 10 seconds. He gets.
Wait,
he didn't go for the armor breaker. Dude, this guy's playing like in the future. What the hell?
And Macaron able to clutch it out right there in the very, very end.
Playing from the future, I'm pretty sure. Only answer I have for this.
Man, let's take a look at that sequence again. That was so, so close on both sides.
So clean. Wow.
And yes, of course, we have to say thank you to the showman here tonight, my boy Fabs. Can I say spending the night with me? Does that sound a little bit wrong, Fabs? What do you think?
Sounds amazing. I agree. We are spending the night.
We're spending the night together watching some high octane MK with the best community out there on Twitch and on YouTube. We appreciate you guys. We hope you enjoy the show so far. Thank you for tuning in.
Indeed. And hope you guys are having a great time watching this, because I am as well. This potential first three of the night. I hope not. I hope Jet Ring turns up in the next few rounds. He's getting the max run treatment, pretty much. There we go. Gets to jump in over that bloodshot. Nice interruption there. Macron is so aware of players' timings and stuff like that, and everything they do in the neutral.
Oh, Holly, thank you so much for the gifted sub in the channel. And do I see that we are close to another hype train and Motor City? Another Jack Scott in the chat. Thank you so much, brother, for the resub. And of course, thank you so much for the beautiful message I received last week. I appreciate you. Thank you guys so much for always showing up in the chat, always showing love as well. But Makuran is in trouble now.
He is. You can see he's trying to floss block and stuff. I feel like we might see a teleport into floss block up two for Makuran soon. Don't know when though, but soon. Oh my god, he just read that so well. Full health. Take health from him. Nice. Oh no, he whiffed! 2-1-2 whiffs after the... Oh my god. Might be a buff Scarlet moment, but it's over though. There we go. Jet Ring does not care though. It's his turn. The trade. Be careful. The zoning he's been getting lots of mileage from in this game, in this set overall. And Jet Ring is pretty much playing on a defense. I mean, just rushing side, pretty much. Macron has control of this whole set. There we go.
Scarlet can counter. Get that life big back so quick.
I know.
And again, not a single up two has worked so far.
Yeah, you might start. I mean, I'm surprised Macron didn't go for a special move over there just to punish that. So his turn. Oh my god, the movement. The escape failed. So if Makuran takes this round, he has a pressure blow for the next, but he does not need that though, because wow. That wake up fatal hurts. And that's how Jet Ring takes the first game of the set.
That was just straight up disrespectful, in my opinion. The second time we have seen that. And look at Molar City spending love here in the chat, gifting ad free viewing experience to two community members. Thank you guys so much for subscribing to this channel. Of course, for gifting a sub, because that's exactly what keeps this going. Thank you for helping me personally as well. Wait, where's my prediction? Oh, there it is. 90% on Marco. 250,000 channel points, fams.
No, right? Jet Ring is definitely making people shake right now with these wins that he's been getting. He's collecting these rounds. So if we get a game five again, I'm pretty confident we can get a game five easily, because Jet Ring is, I mean, that was a 2-0 round lead that he had last game, so wouldn't be surprised if he gets another one right here.
Look at Motor City is going crazy. He wants that hype train. Thank you so much.
Round one, fight.
Nice, the reversal throw on the pokes. Maybe might be something he should invest a little bit more though, because he's pressing down two and not sending ones. It might not be what he's looking for. Nice, because he gets the conversion from that. Any damage he can potentially get, he also capitalizes on it. So good stuff here from Jet Ring. A nice interruption and read. Wow.
Oh shit, Fabs. The hype train has started, and now Big Bubba and Lady Elmo alongside Motor City They are going crazy in the chat. Choo choo, everyone.
Let's go. Oh, nice confirm.
Okay, chat, since the community is going crazy, I think it is time for the arena banger.
Let's go.
Chat, make some noise, everyone!
Round two, fight!
Level 4 hype train, and it is not stopping yet! Now an anonymous gifter is joining us!
Dude, that happens though. Jet Ring still in the lead here. Hitting those down twos, hitting those reversal throws as well. Looking so sharp on this game for it.
Fips, look at this hype train!
I know, Chat is going crazy. Jet Ring is also going crazy here.
What oh my god, what's happening?
What is happening right now? And we also might have a game 5 in our hands as we speak right now.
Jet Ring! The parry from Marco!
Oh wait, no way, he didn't down 2 that. He just went for down 1 instead of killing? Hold on a second. Jet Ring, just throwing an empty box. That's crazy.
Oh, Marco, wait a minute.
Oh my god, the life is already pretty much hit confirm range. He gets something and he might kill. Imagine teleport into Floss Buck up 2. Oh my god. Oh, the boiling point trades!
He cannot crazy. Take. Ladies and gentlemen, with the help of this community, and while we are sitting on a level 5 hype train, we have another game 5 on the menu.
Wow. Wow.
Bro, Fabs, this is just straight up insanity. The community going crazy in the chat, the players going crazy on the big stage. What a combination.
There's a lot of game 5s today, I'm not going to lie. And on top of that, we get a hype train. We also get Wiggs Arena. This is the perfect goodbye to the game I'm seeing right now.
It really is. The community is giving MK11 a proper goodbye. And now I want to see the entire chat completely lose it. It is time for Disco Combat. Let's see how far we can take this bad boy. Level 5, 6% crushed.
Let's go.
Round 1, fight.
Let's go. Macro and still. Oh, nice. Capitalized on that very, very well. There we go. Making a read with those teleports is what he should be doing the whole set, but I guess he's more content with just zoning. But now he knows the timings that a Jet Ring might throw a projectile, and he will go for more teleports when he's zoning. I'm guessing. Nice with the punish as well. Not much damage there, but anything counts with Scarlet. Nice punishing. Nice blocks. There we go. First confirm from Jet Ring. Drop the combo short and get. Oh, that string is working so well for him. Fatal. There we go. Oh, punish. No punish. Oh.
Oh, Fabs, that is huge.
I thought he was just going to like board for it. But he went for back 3 instead.
And the Kellerick, he is keeping this hype train alive, everyone.
Boy's in trouble here. The boy's in trouble.
Oh shit, what is the community doing?
Where are we going? What are we doing today? It's a crazy day. I'm loving this.
What is this hype train? Big Baba, Kellerick, thank you guys. From the bottom of my heart.
Saw 3 boiling points connect in a row. And his health is gone at this point. The far teleport. Tries to press? Oh my god, I'm getting a little
This is crazy. What is happening? They want to see that level 10 in the chat. Anonymous, thank you for the drop sub. Marco fighting for his life.
When he gets the final round, oh my god, he was looking for any button from Jet Ring just so he could get that 4-4 to connect. And we have a set point situation, final round, final point, game 5. Also, hype train, everything is here.
Everything.
These players are just going at it right now. Full screen situation, do we get a leap, do we get anything? Leap? Oh, tries to anti here.
Nice awareness from Marco.
There you go, back to full screen. to trade. Doesn't get much from that. Floss blocks. Doesn't punish the short hop. Oh, the blocks right here. Oh, you see the pressure getting to them when they just block and do nothing. Gets the hit.
Robo, thank you so much for that.
Any shimmy right now would kill Matra in this situation because he has no breaker. Jet Ring just looking for anything. 10% of people voted on Jet Ring right now. They're looking happy. He gets the hit. Doesn't connect though. Auto shimmy doesn't connect as well. Plus again. Presses. Boss blocks doesn't go for anything. Micron still in neutral. Jet Ring looking for that last hit. Oh, the teleport. He just wants to connect any string and torpedo cancel. There we go. Oh, doesn't.
The parry.
Oh, the parry. 10 seconds.
10 seconds. 9, 8. Marco tries. That looks like an input error. Gets off.
No, no. Got down two. Left him recovering for so long, and Jet Ring was like, "That is not my problem whatsoever."
No, I think that was the worst input error at the worst timing.
And the predictions of all time.
What is the community doing? What is Robo and Big Baba and an anonymous gifter doing?
Going crazy.
Perhaps they are really going crazy while Jet Ring secured another W on his potential way to become the first arena champion in season 15 on the PlayStation side.
Yeah, wait, have you have any NA champions so far?
Aztec.
I mean, any. Oh, Aztec won NA. Okay.
But I have to talk to this community, and this is so hype. I actually have to put my sunglasses on here. Shout out to Mr. Aquaman. But I want to say one thing real quick, because the love in the chat, it is literally unreal right now. Thank you guys so much. And I especially want to say a big, big thank you, because this community, Fabs, they are not only providing for the players, but you can see it right here with that hype train. They're actually supporting me as a content creator, right? At the same time as well. So thank you so much, everyone. It helps tremendously. I say that a lot, I know, but I really want you guys to know that I mean it. I love every single one of you. Thank you for allowing me to host these events and for being here. But now, the players, Yuvility, Rinsler, are you guys ready?
Oh my god, Rinsler back on the main stage right now. We've seen some noob sidebot action from him. And Yuvility looking to get that top 3 spot right now, rushing for that. Still has a long way to climb though, but let's see.
Level 8 hype train, am I seeing this right?
They're going crazy today.
This community is different.
Very different. Rinsler, the jump in into back throw. He's chilling now, he's chilling. Oh, the first. Missed the hit from right there, Yuvility. Not looking as sharp as you think you would, but still getting the hits that he needs to get. Oh my god, that immediate response to the projectile with a back two leap. Looking sharp. Gets the hit confirmed. And potential death right now, inbound.
Oh shit, Holly is joining the party as well.
Insane stuff from Yuvility already. Looking really strong. Rinsler might be the player who in this top 8, top 16, let's say, played the most characters. I've seen Kano, seen Cabal from him, you saw Baraka, you saw Noob Saibot. Who else does he have in his inventory? Wow.
Rep range.
There from Yuvility, keeping the corner positioning, and he just jumps away from that. Big damage. There's not a breakaway yet. Getting the breakaway, but a little too late on this side. Oh, the Emperor
on Yuvility sent has to pay the price for that.
Final round.
Rinsler. Second round. Big whips right there. Luckily, Yuvility had no meter. Still capitalizes on it. staggers. Attempting auto shimmy right there. Doesn't work though. But he really looking super strong, just blocking anything that comes his way. Another whip. Oh, second time Rinzo drops that and eats another mid at his way. He's pretty much dying for dropping. The recovery for dropping a combo with new sidebot is so, so big.
Another, wait, okay, kill? Can get a lot of damage.
He might
out of
kill. That. He might kill. I think this is supposed to kick him, not gonna lie. Unless I'm wrong about my new sidebot mats, but. What are you, 9?
Shimmied in the last moment.
Killing him just with 2% health. Just with 2% health right there. And he really makes the first game happen for his side. First blood.
Oh, Phelps, we are literally making history today with the community together.
That's for sure, really. Everybody's coming together today for this final MK11.
That is true.
This final MK11 top 8 right here. And the players are also turning up as well. We're getting so many game 5s, so many final rounds, many hype moments right now. It's so, so cool.
Round 1, fight.
Here we go. Back to neutral though. Back to Spirit Ball. I think Spirit Ball is kind of a little difficult for him to land. And, because Jackie doesn't really want to zone. It doesn't give you a chance to throw that Spirit Ball anyways. Oh, a lot of whips right there. Chilling in the group, losing 3% health. Nothing too crazy. You know, it's just Jackie thing. Here we go. Reversal throw. Look for Oki here. Backs away and starts zoning now. Oh, perfect. Might be teleport incoming. There we go. Ubility knew that was coming. Just another free win.
Round 2. Fight.
And don't forget, chat, coming up next, the Battle of Brothers, Disarded versus Takinada.
Jesus, it is coming, true. In the Sub-Zero mirror that we all are looking forward to see. They better not troll and lose on purpose just to get them more time on screen. I will go to Russia and find them or something. But in game, obviously. Let's go. Rinzler, back to full screen here. The ability, perfectly fine with just holding this, just walking forward. And then, you know, I think he's cool with that because he knows the leap can come at any moment and just get this 40%. But Rinzler also has a teleport in his pocket, so if he makes the right read, he might get lots of damage. But each Spirit Ball he throws, be like, oh, it whiffed. The up shadow he was looking forward so much did not connect when she leaped. And he reacted on time, too. Nice reversal throw. Hold on a second. Needs like 2 hits, honestly. This is Noom Saibot. And this is Jack. He needs 1 hit. What am I saying? There you go. Poke special gets blocked. Ability doesn't have the life lead and time is running down. Hits the poke special. You should just block for your life. Yeah, 7 seconds. The throw might be coming. There we go. Wait. He rolls away. Now roll. He rolls into the corner, by the way. He rolls into the corner, which is just. Wow. Hold on a second. Connects it. Can we get interactable there? No, we do not. Doesn't like me. Fine. Wait, 2-2 in the corner. Gets the group down. Doesn't punish the roll.
I'm not getting away with that Jim Jim attempt.
Oh my god, just empty jump into the 1-1. I'm liking what I'm seeing from both of these guys. Ooh, the Jackie throw whip. It's a poke special. Where's that poke special coming? I know he's looking for that. Wins the trade. Big whips. Good blocks. Oh, no! Oh, again! He dies for this team.
And yes, humility. He is not letting this one slide. Immediate fatal blow hit confirm. And that means second round secured. Rinsler on the edge of getting kicked out of this top eight.
Rinsler has dropped that down one into back one conversion three times. And those three times, your ability punished it.
Bubba, not again. Not again. Chat, I hope you know what to do. BBF, aka our one-man hype train, just dropped another bomb, and with his donation, even though it makes me a little bit sad here, it literally just said, goodbye, Mortal Kombat 11. Big Bubba, thank you so much for always supporting these great players, the stream, since day one. You're an absolute legend, and I'm proud to have you as a friend. I think perhaps for MK1 we actually need like little community logos for the sponsors. We might not have sponsor, but we have something better, and that is the power of this community. Imagine a little BBF Tigris logo and everything spinning there at the bottom. SP Bowler, of course, as well. We have Don and so many more. Robocop with a little Test Your Might logo. I like the idea. I think we're going
to
do something.
All right. Shout out to the people that donate. Have them on screen. And I'm pretty sure they would love that. But also make people more willing to support the stream, right? So we love that. But back in the action, though, Rinsler just snapped his fingers and woke up. What's going on in here? Oh, the reversal. The back throw. Give some Oki to Jackie. What's going on here? The safety is what he kills with. Doesn't go for any mix or nothing. Just 1-1-3 shadow. Nice. Up clone. Gotta be careful whipping those, because as we can see, Jackie can punish anything he whips mid combos if he drops. So Rinsler has to tighten up his execution a little bit more. Nice shimmy right there. Another. All meterless.
And Rinsler.
So good. Almost a flawless, pretty much. He literally flawless blocked whatever the ability did. This round was fast. Inefficient.
Oh,
Rinsler.
Yeah, it really was. Chat, I think we need to power up Rinsler. I want to see at least 150 EOS in the chat. Drop this right now.
Crazy, right? I feel like he's making up for the drops he did, you know, before, and just turned up the heat a little bit. And I respect that a lot. But I mean, for every loss, you know, you do get better. So, utility, we will also see an immediate response from him this round. So, prepare to see both of these players playing at their max right now, because one needs to close it immediately and one has to go to game five.
And, Fabs, and this is where you see it. I have a great way to announce the next set as well. Fight.
Mm-hmm.
Should I do it?
We wait a little or we go straight in.
Should I do it? Disordered versus Taki coming up next.
There we go. The 4-2 of Doom. What holds everyone hostage in this game? The ability gets the hicker from for that 4-3 and finishes it.
The chat is saying professional production. Round two. I mean, that's what Fabs and me are known for, you know, the most professional events in the MK realm.
Yo. The hit. 25. Oh, a little input error right there. No biggie.
But joke's on you guys. Why are more than 300 people live here watching this?
Oh, gets it. Oh my god. Hit by the second hit of the 4-1-2 shrink. Big punish on that. Doesn't go for the full meterless crushing blow there, but gets something out of it anyways. Oh, big whip. No punish. Oh, Rinsler answers immediately. Potential 40%. Goes for the shimmy. Ability still has his turn, still has a throw, and has fatal as well. Don't get hit by the low or anything whatsoever. And he gets it. Wow. Another chance for Rinsler to bring out the game five against Ability.
Oh, the down 3 leap with autocorrect messes up his input. Oh.
Oh, dash punch, yes. He's on point, he's on point. Utility locked in, not missing anything pretty much at this point. He knows his homework, knows everything. And Rinzer answering back. Oh, that almost hit him. Gets the spacing he needs. Blocks low, still plus. Double goop, ball blocked. Fatal blow in play for Rinzer.
Oh, he gets the hit. Anti-air.
Empty jump. Text as well.
Ooh, potential. Hit confirm, place.
He's just jumping for his life. Any anti-air could kill him as well. The madman.
That is it. That is it. Yep. One wrong decision from Rinzler and Ubility saying thank you very much. GG's, well played. See you later.
GG's, indeed. GG's. Great decision making there from Ubility, knowing that his leap would put him in a great situation to either close the round or keep his pressure up. And yeah, good stuff, good stuff. Rinzer also had a crazy run in this tournament, bro, playing with pretty much every character he had in his pocket, and he won a game at least with every character he had. So good stuff there for him.
Oh, I agree with that, Fabs, and that means Ubility making it to the next round alongside Jetring.
You know, so upside we have the brothers mirroring, and on the lower side we have a Ubility Jetring matchup.
And now it is time for the winner finals. It's gonna be the battle of two arena champions, two brothers, and they are here once again, this time in the winner side. Yesterday we saw them in losers. Let's see what match we're gonna see.
I know. Pretty much Sub-Zero brothers going at each other. Lore accurate, probably. His quietly eyeing beyond. Nothing too crazy, you know? We already know the lore for this. What is going on here? What are you guys putting on my screen? Rambo pick.
Baraka.
In a... Okay. Rambo. You know what? You know what? You know what? You know what?
Is going Rambo!
You know what? Why not?
This is ridiculous. We get Baraka versus Rambo.
After making this tournament with Sub-Zero, right, the whole run, and then you go, let's go Baraka here, you know, why not? I respect it.
This artist is basically just saying, Rotha who?
Fight.
He's like, Rotha didn't get to win his finals using Rambo, you know, but...
Wait, he's nice somewhat cooking.
Nice punish already. Oh, okay, got combos. He's not playing around with this Rambo. I don't even know what's going on. These guys are just gaming. There you go. Oh, the up three. Claymore beats the grab. Nice. For the Egoferms. Reversal throw. Nice. Check. Oh, good stuff. He does the whole extension. It's like minus 22. Does not care. He will put that move out. Fatal blow in play for both. Will we see anything here? A walk up fatal. I dare you. Oh, not. Okay, good stuff here. Takenada takes the first round with this this little crusty Baraka, you know what? But I'll allow it.
That Rambo is kind of solid.
Oh, the punish. Wait. No breakaway? This is gonna hurt. Double KB. There we go. 50. Almost. Well, just 50 because of that damage, but still. And the pressure here. Nada. Just trying his best to get out.
Oh, the quarter was so nasty.
Good stuff here. Game one.
Takinoda.
Goes to the younger brother.
And Taki is saying still better than Rotha.
Oh my god. These guys, bro, these guys.
What is the next character gonna be?
A Baraka mirror. Oh, okay, my eyes need to get cleansed.
Have mercy guys, with us.
What's up with brothers meeting up in tournaments and just doing this to our eyes? You know what? I'll accept it. Gutted and Baraka Barrage. Wait, is this? What the hell is Baraka Barrage? Enlighten me. Oh, he's regular Marauder. Okay, it's the extended strings. Okay. The extended limbs. Yo, hits it. Sweep. Take her firm. Better break away. Still 30 with the breakaway. Jesus Christ. Positioning.
Get sniped there, spine burst.
Yeah, Baraka with the extended limbs pretty much on his pokes. Dude, he's pretty good, pretty good. I like whenever people use that move, but not very popular anymore since pokes got a little nerfed in this game. Nice. That's death.
Round two, fight.
Blocks. That's the punish. Oh, that's so clean. The 4-2 punish on the amplified fireballs. Looking good here. He's already doesn't go for the question blow. Yeah, saving it, saving it.
Good whip punish.
Oh, that's big damage. How is he gonna go for the question blow? Or for the gutted? He goes down. No breakaway for this artist. So next hit will probably GG them. If he gets the other question blows. Oh, these trades, he will take it, right? Attacking out of with fatal blow in play. Oh, the reversal throw. Also spends the KB. He has the easy question blows on. What is this guy, bro? This guy. Easy KBs. They're exposing him real quick. Oh, punish the flag immediately. But pokes, you know, why not? Oh, there we go, track it for 20%. We'll miss him next game, but it's fine. No KB, no amplification. All good. Blocking going on. What am I watching right now? There we go. Back connected. Breakaway, but yeah, so much damage to breakaway anyways. And the walk up. Jesus Christ. Oh. Tries to shimmy, and he lands it.
Oh, Takinoda, he might be superior.
Honestly, this artist just switches Sub-Zero and make it happen.
This artist, I hate to break it down to you, but that's just the way of life. Someday, you know, you wake up and it's time to pass the flag to the younger variation. Generation, I mean, not variation.
Variation.
Or I can say to the younger variation of you.
The hourglass.
And now this order is getting serious.
Alright, let's go. Zero. Out of the closet. Not playing around though. Now this might be a big diff right here. A little low spear right there for the mix-ups if you need. Oh my god, it's gonna hurt. Breakaway, you do it, and you also get a 30% for that. Baraka pretty much gets 30% every time he hits you, even if you have breakaway. Oh, wait a second. That's death.
In Takinata, hold on. Is he making it happen with Baraka all the way?
This is Baraka legit. What's going on? Oh, didn't punish with the crushing blow. Would have been so much damage, but it's okay. Zara's like, you know what? I'm tired of losing. Let me mix a little bit more. Blocks.
Where's the punish?
You missed the crushing blow punish. Sit down too. The whips. Oh my god. Pokes. He still confirmed? What? Okay, that was crazy. 20%. Blocks the short hop, and that is next round, baby. Gambling and out on the short hop means you might also die.
Otaki is still on match point.
There we go, Takinata. Potentially just get a 3-0 right here. Quick sweep to move on for grand finals. We doubled on one. The move mission shenanigans right there from Sub-Zero. You know how it goes. Pokes? This is interrupting everything you can do. Nice throw, puts him to full screen. I speak up with the neutral ice ball though. Again, making him chase him the whole time. Oh, I knew he was inputting that the whole time. I saw him. The up two option select from Baraka. Looking so good. Wait a second. It's a confirm.
Oh, wait a minute.
33. He gotta dash up. Oh, he dashes up to him. Oh, the mix up. 43. Neutral ice ball. Don't trade with that. Nice blocks.
And Saki cash it out.
All in the freaking slide right there. Kind of scary. You live for the slide, die for the slide.
And Saki Nada secured the spot in Grand Finals, sending his big brother to the lower bracket.
That was crazy. Shout out Baraka. Seeing Baraka twice in this top 8 was kind of crazy.
It really was.
Maybe that's a secret. That's a secret.
And your ability leave the match. Let's take a look at our bracket, Fabs. So
bracket,
here
bracket,
we go, back at the bracket.
Long day of gaming, but we're nearly done. Our top 3 is pretty much formed, so. Top 4, I mean.
Yep, there is Takinata. And that means Disarded in the lower side now.
Wow, Takinata sitting in grand finals right now.
Yeah.
With Baraka. Big body Baraka.
Disarded potentially gets the rematch as well.
Yeah.
But before that, it is time for Uvility versus Chetring.
Fighting for top 3, pretty much. Let's see. Let's see what happens here.
Thank you.
Right. Looking at this game in hindsight, I mean, what a run the Jet Ring made, by the way.
Jackie,
everyone voted
agree, yes.
Every single prediction, they had Jet Ring as the underdog. Every single one, and he beat them. Since yesterday, actually. Since yesterday. I mean, since top 16.
Yep.
So what a run for this guy. And now, going into this matchup with this Jade, everyone obviously says Jade beats Jackie, Jade beats Jackie, Jade beats Jackie. But you know what? Let's see. Jade does get her winning condition when she gets glow, and then Jackie tries to do a pressure with goop, but Jackie can just not do goop in the air. She's grounded pressure. Oh, nice wiggle stick. Wait. Jet Ring winning the prediction for shortly. Short moments here.
Yeah,
also,
of
he
course
has to
the chat is making it 69.
Oh, down twos. Of course he's Jay play. You know, I was like, this guy down doing so much with Joker. What's going on with the cash here? And he goes to Jade. Now this is more natural. And I love it. Oh my god. Ability so dominant on these last like 15 seconds with this character.
Round two. Fight.
Another, wow, that jump too, pretty much hitting from anywhere on the screen. Oh my god.
Oh, that is good.
Wow. Big damage. Nice, squeezes out every damage as he can. Now he can just safely play from behind. Oh my god. Those down twos are crazy. Helios. Tries to down two, but double group beats down twos.
That is checkmate right there. Uvility, 1-0 up. Mr. Black, what's up, brother?
Uvility playing really confident right now. I guess you know that. I appreciate sure it really like doesn't mind playing against Jade. But, I mean, is Joker Jackie a bad matchup?
I don't think so. And Jet Ring, I think he heard you, Fabs. We're going Joker. And if I remember correctly, right, Jet Ring played Uvility in Winners Round 1. Yeah, there it is. First set, Uvility took it 3-0.
We get a rematch today, huh?
And I'm pretty sure he started with Jade there as well and then switched to Joker in the last round.
He's following the same pattern. What's going on? There we go now. Already seeing from neutral, first, second in the game, Uvility backs away. So kind of gives you a little hint of what's going on here. Uvility might want to play defensive against Joker and just get leaps. Nice answer from Jet Ring though. His reverse game is really solid. I've seen reversal throw, reversal down to and reversal auto shimmy. And what a round from this guy. Oh my god.
Round two. Fight.
Another wow. Answers immediately with a freaking crushing blow. 43% down from the ability. Finally gets a hit. Oh my god, dope. Uvility getting that corner positioning immediately. Jet Ring, might see side switch combo? No, it doesn't have enough gravity to make that happen. Ooh.
But no jail.
Jesus, those
there it
mind
is. Uvility gets another chance.
Uvility, short hopping. Like, he can short hop overhead, short hop, grenade launcher. Or there's so many mind games he gets from that. And so people just get caught so often because it's powerful. Jackie's winning condition is just there. Just jump and your winning condition is right there. But yeah. That thing chases you for so long. Just buying time, really. This is good for him. Like, that's 3 seconds he just won. And 3 seconds might not seem like a lot, but in the game like Mortal Kombat, that's a lot of time. He jumping in the goop, staying there. Nice blocks. Immediate response there. He knows when to throw the dash punch to punish stuff, which is really, really cool. You're really just perfectly fine with backing up, you know? I think he's okay with this. Having Joker chasing you, honestly, is really good. You don't want to chase Joker in tech. He has really good keep away tools in this situation, so smart stuff from your ability.
Oh, nice. Wait, this is close.
Leaps away. Tries to make a read on the goop with the leap himself, but not really working here. Jet Ring needs to make something happen. Oh, gets the trade! Get a blow in play, gets the throw. Nice tech. Maybe the auto shimmy will work there better. Oh, he stops blocking! What is that? That's death. It's not death. Oh! Okay, the funny part here is, you've really had like 1% more health than Jet Ring, so he had no reason to dash into him. So that's, wow.
We have to take a look at this replay.
Yeah, check the health difference between, right at the end. So Jet Ring with 46 health, right? 26 health for Jet Ring. Does the combo. You've really had more health. Oh.
Yo, that was
and like
wild.
I said, 3 seconds left as well. Yeah. 3 seconds left. Oh, that was crazy. Good stuff. But I mean, the best answer for Jet Ring right there would be throwing the Jack in a box because, yeah, he was perfectly safe from anything Jackie could do. Even if she leaped, I think that might have hit her. So, oh my god, immediately with the 4-2 response on the round start. Seconds, I mean, every round that started, you really start by walking back, I guess. And I think Jet Ring is getting used to the situation. Nice shimmy connecting. Big damage here. Already, look at this massive life lead already. He really needs to do something immediately, otherwise this is a free round for Jet Ring. And he takes it. Wow, looking super strong. Still has his crushing blows on the pocket as well. So if he gets a big punish, that's big damage coming through. Plus. Oh, he jumps. It's amazing. Interruption, big stuff there from Ubility.
Leaping out of the pressure zone.
Nice punish, huge punish for Ubility actually, huge punish. He needed that so much to take the round. Yep, took his breakaway. And now Ubility is looking super solid for the next round because Jet Ring has no defensive options. And starts to throw. Wow. Another reversal grab. I like how he enforces his reversal game really well because you expect him to just auto shimmy or fold one after like on reversal, but he's throwing on reversal, which is like kind of free damage if you think about it as a Joker player. Because he would duck West against Joker, right? Nice, pick it up. Oh.
How did that though two not connect?
I know.
Unfortunately, Jet Ring's cane is not long enough. Oh, I saw the down too.
Nice. Still in the goop though. He does have Fatal Blow. We might see something here. Ooh, I think he tried to flash carry.
Oh, humility is smashed. And Mighty Unjust in the chat is saying his what is not long enough. I don't know what you're talking about, Unjust.
Goes for the Fatal. Just to get more time, honestly. Breathing room, some say. Good stuff, though. I respect the attempt of a flash parry that Jet Ring did right there, because if he Fatal and then dash forward, he would have armored through the projectiles and he potentially could have killed, but I don't think he had enough health to do that, so.
Ubility in the lead, 2-1.
Jackie Briggs. Fighting for top 3 at this point.
Lost Hive of the Kaitin.
Then let's go. Game four. Really, either close this out right now or gives us another game five.
Man, I would love to see it.
Feeling it. I know, right? These players are duking it out, bro. I'm loving this so far. What a show. That could have been a trade combo, actually. Oh my god, the standing through punish. Because he highly inputted either a Duckle S or a tech throw right there. Good stuff.
The flawless block.
Nice. Crushing blow. Amazing.
Checkmate.
Jump boot. Yep. Can't do anything about it. Can't do anything about it. And we love that. Maybe interactable if it makes you invulnerable to jump away, but not on this stage though. And really, 1 foot already in losers finals. Jet ring not giving up that easily though. That's a back throw. What's for Oki? Oh, he pushes forward this time. Playing a little more aggressive, I see. He's already changing up his playstyle compared from previous rounds. Oh god.
Look at this pressure from Ability.
Oh god. He might want to be in the driving seat a little longer because you don't want to give that ring the time, and he gets it.
Down two is guaranteed, and Ability, he did it once again. We saw that particular match in top 16, round number one, and Ability is able to take it for a second time.
And our top three is established. Takinada awaits in the upper side.
Jet Ring, unfortunately, out fat.
True. Jet Ring did play is one of my favorites on this entire tournament. Not only because he was the underdog in every prediction, but because NA, right? NA, you gotta respect the NA boys for coming on to these tournaments as well, you know?
Yes. I want to say something about that as well. Jet Ring, I appreciate you playing here in these events. It's always a blast to have you on the big stage. And hopefully I'm going to keep seeing you in MK1. Nothing but the best for you, brother. But now, Fabs, Desarded Uvility. Never-ending rivalry. We had it yesterday. No. We're going to see it again today. Let's get this going.
Let's go. And all that happens, Takinada waits in the upper side of the bracket. Jet just chilling. Looking, who is he going to play again? Who is he going to play? Who is he going to play today? Uvility sent to losers by Makaran, who got pretty much sent to losers as well by Takinada. And then eliminated by Jet Ring. So, good stuff there. Uvility for his life now. 4-2 coming through by Desarted. Notice, Zarda plays a creeping ice variation way more than Takinada. Is that the secret sauce? Secret sauce. Go for damage instead of safety. Nice down ones right there. Gotta be careful throwing down ones against Jackie because both of her advancing mids punish any pokes you can do, pretty much. Stuff there.
Oh, Mr. Black, thank you so much for saying that. Yeah, my bad.
Go. Keeps his meter. That might be dead. Dead. Nice stuff from Zarden. Saved his meter as well. So good stuff. Oh my god, you get down four slides already. Of course, Zarden has to make sure you're prepared for anything. Really, he enforces so much mental stacks onto you with the Sub-Zero, and I love that. Ability gets his turn going, and once he touches you, you will feel everything. 40% off of that touch. Oh my god, he didn't have any meter. Pretty sure he had no idea because that was so unsafe. Ooh, nice. Wow, that's standing too.
Oh, double down one, you Ability. Good tech from this, and get off me, just the down two to the face.
Jumps. Oh my god. You Ability trying to stagger the 4-3. It actually hit. If he made the whole string right there, he would have won. But that down one anti-air, though. That down one anti-air. insane stuff from Desarted. Playing really crisp.
Oh man, I need to crash my overlay here for a minute. Thank you guys so much for the support, for still sticking around after 2.5 hours. Fabs, I appreciate you as well.
Let's go.
Yeah, Stormbreaker, that's a banger.
Round one, fight.
All right, Desarted trying to go for... Oh my god! Gets hit by the grenade launcher and immediately presses 1-2 to read his movement ability. What a freaking... What are these guys doing today? This is insane. Nice poke. Gets his turn immediately. That's all you need. Oh my god, the short hop getting caught in the air as well. Now, in the corner, against Sub-Zero, the ability manages to squeeze out. Nice, finds the opening with the 1-2.
Sliding those DMs is Desarted. The ability waking up with violence.
Nice movement with that board 1. Gets the whip punish and gets some damage going on. Oh, wait a second, don't leave him alive. Oh my god, he left him alive. And look what happened. I'm not sure why the villager like didn't kill him. He had a hit right there. I'm confused as to why the villager didn't like, continue to shrink, because he stopped mid-hit. I don't know.
Yes.
That stagger was second time he staggers, and second time he loses a round. So he might want to consider his offense next time. Oh, he was blocking low as well. Unfortunate. He relief blocked right at the end. Oh god. Goes for all unbreakable damage he can right now. Yes sir. Good choice from Desarted. Now he just has to wait for him to come his way. Almost taking it. Playing super safe. Goes for another 4-2. And throw whipping. Everything whipping right now. Everything whipping.
And I don't think Ubility can come back from this. There it is. And Desarted trying to make this quick.
Desarted 2-0 right now, on his way to top 2 with that rematch against his brother. Let's see if he can get it. Let's see if Ubility makes the absolute crazy run from going into losers on round 1 from top 16.
And Mighty and Just is saying, Ubility never won before? No. So far...
Round one, fight.
There we go. Go. Ability, having a variation named last season, even he knows this is goodbye. There we go, starting something here. Getting that reversal spin 3 there just to get the plus frames as well, but... 2 bars a meter for not much damage going on there.
You know what would be funny, Fabs? I want the chat opinion as well. Chat, you know what? Instead of, if we actually get Desarted versus Taki in Grand Finals for the last MK season, option 1 is we just stream the match, right? Option 2 is we tell Desarted to start his webcam and we see a live arm wrestling, 1-2-3, between Desarted and Taki Nada in real life.
Please, make it happen.
But Taki is gonna destroy him though, that's the problem.
Arm wrestling for Grand Finals.
Round 2, fight!
Ubility though, getting the first win on this round. Nice read on that. Corner carry. Doesn't go for the crushing blow. He might hitbox maybe. Oh, those down twos are going crazy today.
Yeah, Jetring, I can't believe it as well. He's saying, I can't believe this is the last MK tournament, MK11, Jetring, but we're going to go crazy with MK1.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Next week, action is back, so.
And Mighty and Just, I don't know if you heard it in the chat, but most likely the arena is bringing an NA exclusive series as well in MK1. Just a little heads up.
So no more overseas demons.
Yeah. Imagine, Mighty and Just, you can dodge this up, brothers.
Just sign me up. Game isn't even out yet. And he's like, sign me up.
Oh, down for slides.
There we go. Check him with the down one.
Good
air to air
from this, yeah.
Good stuff there. Ability, another hit confirm. 40% nation. Oh god. Started. Inside switch.
Okay, no breakaway from him.
He literally had breakaway available for him. I don't know why I didn't go for that. And then it cost him. Wait a second.
And that flawless block was so clutch from this. Uvility's journey is over here in the arena. And that is not a friendship, everyone.
But you know what? Since you're leaving this game, since you're all going, we just faded you for one last time, you know? The last person he's gonna get fatal'd by in this game is his artist, so he's making sure he remembers this.
And Phelps, I hope you know what that means.
Yes, brothers in Grand Finals. I swear to God, if these guys lose on purpose to give us two game fives and resets and stuff.
It is time for the rematch. The Battle of Brother continues here in Season 15. Get ready for the last battle.
Wait, this means Zarda could potentially be the A-time champion.
Potentially, yes.
Yeah, literally, I'm the same thing. Andras, I'm saying, literally, play this. You're both mains, okay? Don't come in here with freaking Rambos and stuff. Go at it. Sub-Zero, Sub-Zero. Mix each other.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for still being here. I see 330 people live. And now put your seatbelts on for the last battle in one of our league series.
Let's go. Final grand finals, final everything, MK11. Wow. And of course, has to end with Sub-Zero Mirrors, you know? Why not? All right, let's go.
Sub-Zero.
For Deserted. And Sub-Zero.
Yeah,
for
they want to run this series now.
Shaolin Trap Dungeon.
There we go. The end of an era. The Panther Boys, pretty much, as well.
And the chat is saying it all ends with a sub-mirror.
I know.
Chat.
Classic MK11 stuff,
chat,
right?
Drop a 1 in the chat if you think we have to host an emergency event tomorrow just to not leave MK11 with the sub-mirror. Round
1. Some brush our teeth, bro. He's gonna be dirty. There you go.
Look at everybody. That. Okay, guys, you know what? We're hosting another MK11 event tomorrow.
God. Next up. That's not already getting the first. Confirm the top in the corner.
Very, very good in the sub-mirror.
Nice interruption there from Deserted. Are we seeing standing twos into down ones again today? Hope not. Gets the kill.
Robo is saying the Rips Arena All Shiva Invitational Tourney.
God.
Robo? I got you! Everyone, sign up for this special bracket tomorrow! Professional events!
Meanwhile, let's get out of here. Going crazy right now. Not that we are surprised or anything, but hey, it's the Sub-Zero combos we see back and forth.
Phelps, I honestly don't even understand why people still watch my stuff.
Oh, he wins the trade! Oh my god, and he gets it.
I only think the only reason is because no one else is live right now. Final
round. Nah, people like the content. People like the content, it's fine. Nice interrupt. So, Tatumana getting something going. Started. He needs to win. Two sets, by the way. Because he's coming from the lower side of the bracket, so. Nice block. Wait, this can finally kill.
Oh, there we go. It.
Game one. Goes to older brother.
But don't forget, Desardit has to reset the bracket. Oh shit, Rip's bald head still going crazy. And Desardit is saying, where is the final overlay? You know what, Desardit? Let me give it to you. Everyone, I need the chat to make some noise. Thank you so much for the support for more than 2.5 years.
True.
Carcotton Warcat. Round one, fight.
There we go. Action. Acting out of. I mean, the fact that they pose through like a similar skin as us kind of a mix of itself. But yeah, Acting out of has like the white skirt thingy on him. That's the only reason I can tell. The white skirt. Whatever you call that. Gets a neutral ice ball going on. One trade. Nice 4-2 spear. Good stuff there. Not gonna kill potentially, but gets the poke to finish it off.
Round two. Fight.
Oh my god, that's low. Corner carry. We just dropped the combo halfway and gets punished for whipping that poke. L4 always get punished so easily in this game now. I love that. One of my biggest concerns this game was like the first 2 years down fours were so hard to punish. It's a 4-2 ice ball. Hype his L, of course. Best, hardest move to hit in the game.
And all these staggers.
I know, right? Oh,
overhead to the dream.
He does have a breakaway and uses his meter to roll back. Interesting. Puts himself in the corner. Down two from downtown. Side switches, because why not? What was that wake up stand switch? Explain to me what's going on over there.
Final round. Fight.
Plus, still going for his turn. And there we go. I can now get something going. Crushing blow. Oh my god, wake up down twos are probably the most. I've never seen too many down twos hit as much as I see today. This Tape has only like random down twos hit, I think.
That guy. To the stomach fast. Wow. And they started right now unstoppable.
Really close to resetting this. What the hell?
Desardit is one round away from getting that bracket reset, Fabs.
I know, right? Like, in full power, because he literally just lost the previous set 3-0 to Baraka, and now he's winning in the mirror, so I don't know what's going on right now. Let's go.
Good tech.
Is that a skin switch? Yes, we did. Skin switch. Got out to the disorder for switching the skin there, guys. So you can know. Wait, is it disorder? No, it's actually not a switch with the skin. Yeah. Nice. Short hop.
Robo saying they are brothers. They should have just agreed to split the prize and put on a show with weird characters. I think the thing is, Robo, it's kind of important to them, honestly, who is going to go into MK1 as an arena champion. I really think they are fighting more for the title right now.
I think also the players, the characters they play the best is Sub-Zero, so their show is playing Kijuri. You know, like, it's the character they play the most optimally, so might as well just go for it.
Round two.
It's one last time, you know, might as well cook with the last of the mirror of the freaking era. Exactly, Mighty Interest, exactly. Oh, nice block on that. Amazing punish as well, spinning the ice ball. Escape failed, loaded for Disarted. His next back throw will hit for 30.
Over.
His art is staying alive for as much as he can. Oh, there we go. The blocks coming through on that overhead. That was the big risk that he needed.
And Tucky is on the board. I mean, he still has that safety net of the bracket reset available. And Arn, do you already have a character? I see Arn Kratos in the chat, by the way, for everyone watching this on YouTube. Arn, do you have a favorite character who you're going to play in MK1? Are you looking at Shang, potentially? Or do you have another favorite already?
He's for sure thinking of Shang already, this main, you know. No doubts whatsoever.
I would love my ass off if Arn is going to go Sub-Zero in MK1 just to pay it back to all the subs he had to face in MK11.
Christ. That would be a nightmare, but hey, I believe in it. Oh, breaks the armor with... that's something you don't see often, but breaking the armor on the interactable with the Ford 4 is so, so cool. Getting all the features are happening today, you know? Every single MK11 feature showcased in this top 8. That's what I call a good showcase. On 2KB. One last time, you know?
But right now, Fabs, Tucky is somehow bringing this back. Fight.
I know, right? That variation switch, looking good for him. Nice block. Hold on a second. SKB, 38, literally meterless. Nice blocks. Hooks after that? Wow. Oh my god, that is too... Four rounds in a row for Sakinada, I'm pretty sure.
Oh boy, oh boy. This first match is going the full distance already. Sakinada on tournament point.
Would be so crazy if Disarted wins and resets the bracket and we get another game 5 after. I've seen this movie already, you know? I've seen this movie.
Untratos is saying, Rips Arena, so when you gonna tell people that you decided to move to Counter-Strike 2 after this season? Arn, I was waiting for the right moment to announce that. Arn and me, we decided, you know what, let's just skip MK1. We're gonna go professional in CS2. Even though playing Counter-Strike with Untratos, chat, how can I say it? We call him the walking decoy for a reason, you know? It's like playing with handicap. I
you
always
die
have
the
to
whole
carry
time. Oh my god.
Round one, fight.
Alright, game 5 situation. Could we see Takinata sweep this? It's a 3-2 and end the tournament right now, or Desarted could get a potential reset. Life lead favoring Takinata so far. We've punished that body. Corner positioning now. Ooh, reversal down too! Wait a second though. He won't die, but. Wait. Oh, big drop! What's going on?
Dude gets blocked!
Why would. Oh, he dropped a big, big humble right there. Oh my god.
Round two. Fight!
Down four slide. Takinata. Okay, strong. Close this.
Oh,
the potential flawless so far. Hold on a second. Dex? Oh my god, this. What? Takinata, hold on. And that is tournament.
Takinata, he is our last arena champion on the MK11 side of things. Congratulations. What a run.
Wow, amazing.
Oh, no.
Younger brother takes it.
Perhaps
this is a keeping eyes, actually. I like that.
I'm happy that I'm wearing the shades because, honestly, I'm a little bit emotional right now. The
right?
Last Arena League for MK11 is officially over. And Takinata, he deserved it all the way through. An incredible player, an incredible talent. A big, big shout out to literally every single player playing in our events. And before Fabs and me go out, I want to say one thing here in the end. Even though I look like a clown, I know it, guys. Thanks to all that community support. I just want to say thank you, guys. It has been a wonderful, life-changing journey here on my end. I would have never imagined when I started streaming like 2.5 years ago that I would sit here one day with hundreds of people on Twitch every single day, thousands over there on YouTube. You guys are amazing, and I am very, very proud to say that I have not only the best community, the best team beside me every single day, and an incredible arsenal of great co-commentators, just like Fabs here. Fabs, it was an honor
amazing.
To commentate this with you.
It's my pleasure as well. I love being here. This is amazing experiences that I have so far, you know? So it's my pleasure to commentate these.
Yes. So everyone in the chat, before I start crying here on stream, thank you so much. And we promise that we're going to put in extra much work into MK1 to keep providing you guys with the best possible events, to give you guys the best possible viewing experience alongside some not so professional commentary. That's what we're known for. So guys, everyone out there, a big congratulations once again for everyone who reached top 4, to everyone who reached top 16 in the finals. Uvility, it was a blast having you, and I cannot wait to see what all these young people are gonna do in MK1. But for now, I am out, Fabs is out, and we love every single one of you. Have a wonderful night, bye-bye, and I'm gonna catch you guys again very, very soon. Take care.